Wait until you see the carpet that I'm going to be cleaning today. This one's going to be quite the job for sure. It's definitely seen better days. And these darker areas right here, this is not actually spots, it's just shading on the carpet. But nonetheless, there's still a ton of wear and a ton of dirt in this carpet. So in addition to the living room, I'll be cleaning this hallway. This bedroom. This bedroom, which this bedroom and the last bedroom are definitely the best out of all of them, even though I wouldn't call them good. And this bedroom. And it's not coming across on the camera quite as much as I can see in person, but this area right here is really a lot darker just looking at it. And I know this area is coming across a little darker on camera, but it's also really, really dark looking at it. And a lot of wear and spots right here too. And this house is a rental, and I've done work for the owner before. I've never cleaned at this location though. I also had some questions about what pre-spray I'm using, things about my electric truck mount, and I haven't really did a video showing much on the electric truck mount in a couple years, I don't think. So right now I'm running a Champion generator. I replaced the Briggs & Stratton Vanguard generator with this one, and that generator was still working fine, but it was just old, really old. So I wanted to go ahead and replace it with something a little bit newer, and I still have the other one, so if I need a backup, it's there. But I ended up getting a Champion dual fuel 10,000 starting watts, 8,000 running watt generator. And the thing that I really like about this one is its electric start. Even though my other generator started first or second pull every time, it's still really nice having an electric start. And this one is way bigger than what I need, but also I can use it during hurricanes and things like that. And probably the only other thing that has changed that I can think of is I'm now using a Pump Tech water otter pump, the 1200 PSI one. The general pump that I had on here before, there were no issues with it, but the electric motor that I was using, it went out and I needed a pump pretty quick, and it was quicker to just swap out the pumps with a Pump Tech. This is the same pump that I used before I had the general pump, and it really held up pretty good. With just a little maintenance, it lasted for quite a few years. And I'm still using the little giant propane heater. And as far as my pre-spray for hot water extraction, I'm using Grime Release Pro. I'm still using the Unbelievable Rids Odor, the Spice Green Tea. And I mix in some peroxide when necessary, like on this job. Now all I have is 20 volume because I bought out Sally's of all the 40 volume they had. So I ended up having to get 20 volume, but that's about it. And I know the trailer's messy, but I've been pretty busy lately and that's just what happens. So I went to hook up my water and I found this little deal here. It looks to me like this was probably leaking at some point, and I guess they soldered the connection on, so that left me not being able to hook up to water there. And there is a faucet around the back of the house, but it's way on the other side. And I usually carry an additional 50 feet of hose with me, but I took it out whenever I needed to carry some VLM equipment. So I didn't have it with me, so I ended up having to hook to the faucet with just a faucet adapter, which I always carry. I actually have a rinseroo that I modified for faucets, but I put it on first. You can kind of see right here where I had it on, but it was shooting water out of the back. So I went ahead and just got my faucet adapter to hook up to water. And I really only have to do this maybe once or twice a year. Okay, first I'm going to go over the carpet dry to help dig some stuff out of the carpet and pick up a lot of this debris on top. I'm going to be using just the rear trays on the CRB. I went over the carpet with the CRB mainly because there was a lot of bigger crud and stuff that I didn't want to run my vacuum over. So let's see what came out. So I ran the CRB over all the carpet and all the rooms, especially in this room. They had a lot in here. So I am going to pre-spray, and I'm going to work the pre-spray in with the CRB also because of the condition of this carpet. I was told don't worry about the closets because most of them had stuff in them, but I'm at least going to hit the areas that I can. Not too bad, but I'm going to work on these dark spots just a little bit more. See if I can lighten those up. I think given the age and condition of this carpet, that's probably about all I'm going to be able to do. And you can still see a little bit of the black, but it's really, most of it came up, so I'm pretty happy with the results. finally finished up with the living room, and I couldn't show the actual cleaning of the living room because it's just too dark in here. You know, it's like a dungeon really. And then with that little bitty light right there, I was causing a shadow over a lot of the cleaning. But as an overall, the carpet came out really good considering how old it was, how much wear it has, and how dirty it was. So I'm gonna get wrapped up and I'm gonna dump the water here and we'll take a look at it.